the choice, no, Dad, I don't want a cell phone. Offer a seven-year-old child a cell phone today. You think the child will say no? I've seen three-year-old children knowing how to operate an iPad. Do you know that? Open them. And they know, they press the button and they know how to play the game. Well, they don't know, but you know, they're doing something with the damn thing. I know my son was doing it at the age of 4 or 5. And no one taught him. I'm serious, I never gave him the thing then. So I remember one year, about 3 years ago, I don't know, 4 or 5 then, he took my phone, right? And there was no games on the phone, so he's looking for Angry Birds. So somehow or the other, he ended up on right? He went on to YouTube with Angry Birds, and he's looking at the Angry Birds being played, you know, like a cartoon or something. I don't know what it was. Then. My bill went up to 1,000 rand. I got a heart attack. I became an Angry Bird, literally. I'm saying, Salah, I don't use anything. What happened there? Eventually, when I phoned them, I made a big bus. They said, on a certain day, I'm looking at the time. But I'm in Tarawih at that time. You know, on those phones or on those iPads or something there, you know, they have that thing there where they can tell you, you know, you can go onto YouTube and, you know, that it shows you. Right? The child doesn't know anything. He can't even read or write. He even on the thing, he's watching the thing. Ooh, how nice. He went on for half an hour. Point being that they are exposed to all of these things and they adapt to these things at such a young age. But in terms of what I'm talking about there, almost 99.9% of parents don't even think in that direction towards educating their children towards these things here, because these are the true priorities of life. True priorities are these things here. Who are you going to leave it to? Really, who are you going to leave it to? The Maulana can't sit down and take every child and come say, son, I'm going to talk to you about death. The child will run away from you, man. Really? When? These are the things that, you know what, Ashabul Kahf, this is what the Holy Quran is telling about. I don't want to go into another discussion. Next week is Khawmanillah. And this is very critical. This is the follow on to today's discussion. Standing up. Read that verse, please, as an introduction for it.
It's verse 14.
No, verse number.
We solaced their hearts when they stood up and said,
aha. See? And we placed a tie. Wa rabatna ala qulubihim. And we place a tie. Irtibat means, you know, to give strength, right? And to give solace. You know, right? Ala qulubim idh qamu, when they stood up and said, idh qalu, our Lord.
Our Lord is He who is the Lord of the heavens and earth.
What did these people do? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, when they stood up, right? The Holy Quran, in another verse of the Holy Quran before Surah Fatir, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says there, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Qul. O Prophet of Allah said, Innama a'idhukum biwahida. O Prophet of Allah, tell the people, Innama a'idhukum biwahida. I'm admonishing you, I'm giving you wa'az, I'm giving you advice about one thing. And what is that? What is the one thing the Prophet of Allah is being told to tell the Ummah? Antaqumu lillah. That you stand up for Allah. Mathna. Two. Wa furada. Or one. Thumma tatafakkaru. And then you reflect. Did this message of the Prophet of Allah reach you yet? Innama a'idhukum biwahida. The Prophet of Allah is being instructed by Allah. Tell them that, oh Prophet of Allah, tell them, innama a'idhukum biwahida. I'm advising you towards one thing. Antaqumu lillah. Qawma lillah. Standing up for Allah. Like the Ashabul Kahf did. What did they do? Allah says, وَرَبَطْنَا عَلَىٰ قُلُمْ إِذْ قَامُوا. When they stood up. Right? فَقَالُوا رَبُّنَا. And what did they say? Our Lord is the Lord of the heavens and the earth. رَبُّنَا رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Lord of the heavens and the earth. And Allah is telling another verse, O Prophet of Allah, tell my ummah that they should stand up as two people or one, individually. That's the bare minimum amount. مَثْلَا وَفُرَى ثُمَّ تَتَفَكَّرُوا. And what do you stand up for? You stand up for this. Reflect on this one here. My Lord is the Lord of the heavens and the earth. What does this entail? What does it require of me? Right? What does it demand of you? What is expected of me? What is expected of me? This is what is expected of me. That I'm here for a short period of time of 50, 60, 70, 80 years at best. Or 90 years, you'll be really, 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 really lucky, unlucky, depending. Right? And Allah is telling you what you've lived before. And you're going to live after this. And you're going to live permanently and eternally in the abode there. This is what your life is all about. And what you preoccupied with? Frivolous things. frivolous things. You know, I read one something someone sent to me the other day. They said, you know, the psychologists have discovered that in the last few moments before a person dies, right? Do you know what the person thinks about? You know, literally life flashes before his eyes. It's a psychological fact that in the last moment before the person dies, all his most vivid memories just come before him. What would be your most positive, vivid memory? When I mean positive, vivid memory, I mean in terms of concern. What do you think would flash before your eyes at that time? Most people I know would be worried about the children. Right? Most people I know would be worried about what's going to happen to my business. What's going to happen to my money? Why am I dying? If they love themselves too much, why am I dying? Right? What can I do to... Quran speaks about all this. Quran speaks about this. وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقَنَاكُمْ And give from the path of Allah. مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ أَحْدَكُمُ الْمَوْتِ Right? Before death comes to all of you. فَيَقُولَ رَبِّ لَوْلَا أَخَّرْتَنِي إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ قَرِيبٍ Allah, give me some time. Give me a couple of minutes. وَلَنْ يُؤَخِّرَ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا Allah is not going to give you any more minutes there. What are you going to do? No, I'm going to go back. لَعَرْجِ لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا Right? Allah, let me return. Don't take my life. I'll do good deeds now. فِي مَا تَرَكْتُ That which I left. كَلَّا Allah said, نَعَ إِنَّهَا كَلِمَةٌ وَقَائِلُهَا This is the khalas. Allah has decided. Ask yourself this question. According to psychologists, even if you don't believe in any of you guys, but anyone, they say they've researched it and they've come to a conclusion that the last few things that happened are the vivid memories. What will be your last memories? What will be the hopes that you'll be pinning onto at that moment? Because right now, at that moment, everything is opened. Everything is opened up. You see malaika, you see angels. You're seeing angels in front of you. If you didn't know, and don't hold me accountable, I bloody sat and spoke about angels for a long time here. Right? Fatih says, Rusul Uli Ajaniyahatim Mathna, Wathulatha, Waruba, 2, 3, 4. So if you see 2, 3, 4, hey, how many people are there? I'm sorted at least. Right? What's going to happen to you? How will your last few moments go? In a state of knowledge that, hey, I know what's going on. Okay, I'm dying, but I can see malaika. Okay, this is happening. And those memories that are going to be flashing back, worry about my children. But you know what? Shala, you think you're worried, your children are worried about you the moment you put into the grave. You're only worried about how much money my mother left. How much money my father left. No, I'm very serious. You know, it's a pathetic state of affairs when I hear parents being so concerned about them. I said, Hazratji, hey, wake up. You worried about your children when you die. What happened to my poor child, my poor daughter, my poor son? Salah, your only son and your only daughter thing, you're worried. Half of that thing, when my bloody mother is going to die? When my bloody father is going to die? I hope he drops dead. And the poor mother and father is still worried about what is happening to me, my children, when I die. And they're worried about, hey, how much am I going to I'm going to cash up when my parents die? That's the, you know, the irony of the whole thing. Where parents are so concerned about so many other things, positive things, good things for the children are not even bothered about what's going to happen. What's going to happen to my mother when she dies in the grave? Have you taught your children to think like that? What's going to happen? What can I do to help my father when he goes in the grave? You worried about your children, how they're going to live. Have you taught your children how to worry about when you die, how to worry about you when you die? Like you are worrying about them, how they're going to live when you die. Have you taught your children how to worry about you when you die? But the Prophet ﷺ said, three things remain behind. You know that? That which you gave in the path of Allah, that you spent in the path of Allah, that knowledge which you imparted in the love of Allah, in the path of Allah, and that which you left behind in the form of a pious child who will pray for you after your death. So, are you bringing up children who are thinking and living and practicing the way the Ashabul Kahf are? Or you bring up goofs? In the true sense of the word, goofs. Not Ashabul Kahf children. Not youth like this. Allah gives us the figure, inshaAllah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allahumma alimni ma yinfa'ani wa anfa'ani bima 'allamtani wa 'allimni wa zidni 'ilma. Allahumma alimna ma yinfa'ani wa anfa'ani bima 'allamtana wa zidni 'ilma. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdika nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala sayyidina wa maulana Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wa sallama tasliman katheeran katheeran bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. If I get